Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Wait, What Are We Talking About podcast, episode 96. My name is Brett, a.k.a. Enigma9011, and you can catch this podcast live over on twitch.tv/Enigma9011 every other Saturday at 8 p.m. Eastern. You can check it over there. If you're a sub, you can give you can join in on the conversation. If you're a sub over there, we'd love to have you. If you can't catch it live, that's A-OK. You can go over to YouTube and SoundCloud, where it's broken out topic by topic and put as one big video in MP3 for your amusement on the following Friday. And last but not least, hashtag ad merch store and get all of your swag over there, t-shirts, cups, backpacks, and more. Rep the brand, support us. It would be greatly appreciated. Wouldn't be a podcast without Artemis, so he says hello as well. But yeah, hope everybody's doing well. Hope you guys are having a good week. Flying solo, obviously, once again. But I got some fun, well, maybe not all fun. Got some interesting topics. I'm excited to share my thoughts and feelings about and chat with you guys. So we're just going to jump right on into it with topic number one. As you guys know, well, maybe you don't know, Lady has not converted me, that sounds really weird, has shown me the lovely world of hockey and the NHL, and I've been getting more and more into it over these past couple years. I would say this past season was probably the most I got into it, watching the games and learning the players and just, you know, being invested, having a good time. So leading into this next season of 2021 to 2022, this is my first real noticing or focus on the off season and seeing what roster changes are going to happen going to next year's season. So topic number one is going to be talking about the Colorado Avalanche's roster changes so far as of recording on the 31st of July. Some interesting choices here, some heartbreakers, some daybreakers, some life-altering decisions. Not really. But some big ones here. I have pulled up their Twitter feed, and I'm going to go through that just to kind of remind myself fully who's gone, who's re-signed with us, who's traded, etc., etc. So if you do hear a scroll wheel from time to time, I do apologize about that. We got some players who are staying on the team, which is a good thing. We got Kiefer Sherwood, who re-signed with us, and I believe there was another re-sign as well, another support player. But I think those are good. I mean, they're not obviously standout in the front players, but they definitely, you know, play their role well and were strong on the back side of things when it came to the different lines and obviously like that. And then we got our bigger ones. We had two real, real big ones that, you know, we're happy to keep along. We got Cale Makar resigning for 3 years, I believe it was. And then we got our captain, Gabe Landeskog, for 8 years, which is huge. So yeah, those obviously big wins, big wins. Obviously those two guys, you know, do a lot for the team, whether it's on offense, defense, respectively, or defense, offense, flip that. They do a great job with, you know, what they do. Obviously they get a scoring, they make big plays, and, you know, obviously Gabe's got his captain status, so, you know, keeping the whole team moving in the right direction. So fantastic, obviously, have those guys still around. And then we get to the interesting part where we get to the people leaving and new people joining. So I think to start off, we had Matt Calvert, who's retiring. That's totally different, obviously. I don't think he played much, if at all, this past season due to injury. I could be wrong about that. So that one doesn't hit as much. Like, obviously, he was a good player and good to have him on the team. But, you know, if it's time to retire and you want to hang it up, you know, you do you. Go be happy. That's totally fine. One that we did lost that kind of sucks just because he was a really good defenseman. We got Ryan Graves leaving. I think he was going, where the hell was Graves going towards? I think he was going to Minnesota. Maybe I'm wrong there. Sorry, all the fucking draft picks. I don't care. Well, I mean, I do, but I don't know anything about them, so hard to put my 2 cents in. There's Gabe's news. This is a great for a podcast. Like, Brett almost planned everything here, right? Oh, shit. Well, Graves. Okay, Graves is gone. Connor Timmins is gone. He was a good support player. He's going over to... Okay, he's going to Minnesota. Excuse me. So Graves is going somewhere else. Maybe Graves is going to Chicago. So I think we got somebody from Chicago. We got P. Belmar, who's gone. That one's a more rough one. He seemed like he was kind of more, not a full-on captain, but seemed like he was a very key role for his lines when they did come in. So that one's a interesting choice of why I would let him go. Brandon Saad is gone. I think he had a very short deal. It might have been only a 1 year. So, like, it was one of those, like, let's sign people to kind of make a now move. Unfortunately, obviously, playoffs, we didn't make a now move. We made it to round two, but then got trounced, which has been our pattern for the past couple of years. So that stinks. Saad's gone. So some interesting players there. Hi, Moose. I know, it's a big deal. Some big losses there for at least, like I said, they're not the biggest, like, numbers guys, but I feel like how they played and what they did out on the ice is really going to be interesting going forward this season with them not being out there. And as I'm scrolling here, we did re-sign also Tyson Jost. That's a good one. Another good key player. And then we got the fucking heartbreaker of the millennia and soul-crushing defeat for me personally. So we were re-signed Cale Gabe. Great. We decided, let's not re-sign our goalie. And Philip Grubauer has now left the team and is going to the Kraken, Seattle, for 6 years. Oh, God, that hurts a lot. This is a big question mark to me, too. Now, I understand. The man obviously has shown up his last 2 or 3 years in a big way, especially last year. He played, maybe 90% of the games. Luckily, no injuries, anything like that. Did very well. A lot of shutouts, a lot of good performances, good save percentage. And, like, I get it when you're pulling those numbers. Maybe you want a little bit more money because, you know, hey, I'm doing a good job over here. And obviously he's found that with Seattle. My biggest question mark is, like, did you make a respectable play at least for him? I don't know. Because I hope they did. I hope they gave that man that respect he deserves for, like, what he was putting out performance-wise of offering him a deal. But, oof, that is a tough, tough, tough hit. I don't know if the other goalie we do have, I believe his last name starts with a V. It's not Valanciunas. That's a basketball player. Verlovsky? I don't know. He was out with injury this whole time, this whole season. So I don't know if he's better. The whole goalie situation was rough. We have signed a new goalie, or rather traded. We got Darcy Kemper from Minnesota. So we'll have to see how he does. I'm not going to lie. Like I say, I've been watching more hockey, obviously, this past season. But, like, I don't pay attention much to the other teams. I know there's a couple assholes here and there who do some some rough stuff. But I don't know specifically how Darcy plays. No, you know, could be good. Could have been great. But hopefully this guy, I don't know, can live up to at least a fraction of what Grub had done. But man, that just hurts. Hurts a lot. There's other people on this team who I feel like could have gone. Like, Nazem Kadri's a big one. Like, yes, he's a good player, but I feel like he's got a lot of problems as well, which could also, like, you could say for Graves. You know, like, Graves, I kind of get why maybe you want to scoot him out of there. He had a lot of foul trouble, unfortunately. But man. Oh, okay. This is a surprise. I thought this was only a one-year deal. Excuse me. But I guess Devin Dubnyk is still on the team. He's a good goalie. Played two games this season. We got still Jonas Johansson. He did fine. But, like, Jonas is still young. So, like, that's... he only had a little limited ice time this season. Devin can be good, but once again, only played a couple. So, like, there's not much to go off here of, like, experience, at least that I know of. Holy shit, this shows their salary, too. What the fuck? I'm sure it's wrong. But, yeah, so I don't know what Darcy can do. Obviously, I gotta just give it time. But, man, that sucked. That took a hit. I'm not seeing the injured goalie here, at least in the roster, so... maybe the person's out. I don't know. This hurts a lot. It's going to suck next season when we do eventually play the Kraken and then see Grubbs over there. You know, I wish him the best of success. Duh, of course, along with anybody leaving the team. But man, it's a very interesting decision as to why Grubbs was not a key enough person to keep around. But then again, if you look at some other teams, the Golden Knights got rid of Andre Fleury, which he was a big, key part of that team. And whoop, he's going to Chicago, I think. There's a lot of interesting, weird moves going on this offseason. As for new players, we got Jordan Cross. We got a lot of guys from fucking Minnesota. We got Jordan Cross joining. Who else we got here? We got from the Detroit Red Wings, got Darren Helm to a one-year contract. I think there was... oh, yeah, we got also Dylan Sakura and Stefan Matau, both to 1 year. So, like, I don't know. One-year deals, like, I get it. You know, you want to try out some people, see if it works, see if it doesn't. But... way back when I used to watch basketball more, OKC, Oklahoma City Thunder, that was my team to watch. I hopped into basketball just as they had transferred from Seattle, being the Supersonics, to OKC. So I was like, oh, new team. This makes sense to jump in here. I could have defaulted and been a Knicks fan, but like I felt like new team, perfect for a new fan to hop in there. That was my reasoning there. Eventually, obviously, that team dismantled from what it had been of, like, Kevin Durant being there and Russell Westbrook. So for a little while, especially when James Harden had left and then Kevin Durant had left, we kind of were messing around with different people supporting Russell. And there was 1 year we had Victor Oladipo, originally from... excuse me, at the time, the original Orlando Magic, and then he joined. And Oladipo was great. And when that season came around, like, they did okay. I don't know if they made a super big push, playoffs or whatever, I can't recall. But, like, Oladipo was only in that 1 year, and then they just swapped him out for somebody else. And the one-year deal thing just really confuses me. Like I said, I can understand... like, you want to do a trial period with people. But sometimes, like, I feel you got to give it more than 1 year, one season. Especially with coming from other teams, like, and obviously playing with new people. You got to kind of build a rapport and, like, some kind of camaraderie with them. So, like, obviously off the court or on the court or ice, you got to build that. You got to kind of get used to, okay, my... wing player, really, this is where their strong suits are. How can I support that? Okay, we're going to run these plays, or I got to watch out for this weakness, whatever it is. Like, you got to give people time to kind of mesh together. And I'm granted, a season is 82 games, like, that is a lot of time, but sometimes it takes a little while. Like, these one and done years, like, if they just zip away, I don't know if you really get the full potential out of them. and then we're just going to be in the same struggle bus as or next year. And, you know, obviously we did make some deals this previous season for like 1 year, like Saad and I think Devin Taves has re-signed, but like he was somebody we called in. Like there have been short-term deals that like we want to push for the title. Okay, great. But then when it all falls apart, is it like, did you just blow the budget? Like, is that why everything's falling apart the next year? I don't know. So yeah, with these new signees, like, cool, great. I'm excited to see how they play. I'm sure they'll do well. It's just, once again, going back to Grubauer, the biggest question mark of like, why? You really didn't think that he was key enough to keep around. I get McKinnon. I think he's already got a deal. We didn't have to talk about that. Thank God. I get McKinnon. I get Landeskog. He's the captain. I get McCarr. He's the new kid on the block. I get having those three. Those are your big three. So going back to basketball. But the defensive end, I know Kale's defensive. Your goalie's hella important. Hella important. There's no swaps. Okay, there's the, you know, the replacement guy if something does happen. Like, what are you doing? That was... We didn't have a strong backup. So why would you feel that you can drop him? I just, like I said, I really hope they made a respectable play for him. Some kind of deal. And it just unfortunately didn't go their way. Such a big question mark. And, like, 8 years is a big deal for Landeskog. And, like I said, Landeskog is great. I'm not trying to take away, like, devalue, oh, you signed him for this long. But could you maybe have taken some of that money and, like, scooted over that way? I don't know. It's just, it's very frustrating, to say the least. Hopefully this isn't just a rebuild year. That was my fear the day hearing about this trade. I think it was Wednesday. It's just like, it was a big hit. And, yeah, it's like, oof, you had the thought, or I had the thoughts of like, well, we're going to be, we're back in the rebuilding phase. We're not going to be pushing for those playoffs, I guess. I don't know. Just, it's interesting. Obviously, like I said, this is only my first offseason really paying attention to it, so I don't know if it's been like this from year to year where it's more apparent with the roster changes. Hopefully all the new guys coming in, whether it's through the draft or these trades, acquisitions, whatever, hopefully, you know, they mesh well, hopefully they do well, perform well. You know, I'll eat my words down the road when we push really far in the playoffs or whatever. It's just all of them, it's going to be a hit, you know. Wish nothing the best for them. Hope they do succeed, obviously, wherever they do go. It just sucks not having them on our team. But I digress. I don't know. That's just my thoughts on the roster change. Roster changes, at least so far. Hopefully nothing super big happens in the next coming weeks, but I don't know. I don't think there's a cutoff. I think it's similar to other sports where, you know, trade deadlines like halfway through the season or whatever. But we'll see how it goes. See how the season plays out. We're back to 82 games. So that's cool. More hockey, more sports. Hopefully, as long as, you know, the world stays normal somewhat. But we'll have to see how it all goes.